Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deepcast Reactions, and my name's Greg. And you know, yesterday I listened to what I thought was gonna be the song "This Land Is Mine," and it turned out that it was a little kind of interview, interspersed with parts of the song. You know, it's from a movie, "One Night the Moon," I think it is, and I mean, it was great. They explained all this stuff, you know, about the movie and with Paul Kelly and Kev Carmody and everything. It was really neat, you know, very interesting. But I wanted to just hear the song too, you know. So that's what I'm playing today. So this is "This Land Is Mine," and it's, you know, still a clip from the movie, but let's check it out here.
That's my daughter out there. I'm not having some darky leading the search.
Excuse me, sir. This is Albert's country. He knows this land. Last year.
Now listen here. No blacks on my land. This is my property, and I'm calling the shots. Let's get going.
Get the black tracker off the property.
Oh, Sarge, this mob's going to walk all over every track we got.
All right, man, form up in the line.
This land is mine, all the way to the old fence line. Every break of day, I'm working hard just to make it pay.
All right, break well apart.
This land is mine. Yeah, I signed on the dotted line. Campfires on the creek bed. Bank breathing down my neck. They won't take it away. They won't take it away. They won't take it away from me.
Hup!
Gentlemen.
This land is me, rock, water, animal, tree. They are my song, my beings here where I belong. This land owns me from generations past to infinity. We're all but woman and man. You only fear what you don't understand. They won't take it away. They won't take it away. They won't take it away from me.
This land is mine.
This land is me. This land owns me.
This land is mine.
This land is me. They won't take it away. They won't take it away. They won't take it away from me.
Oh, that was it? Okay. I don't know, it seems like it should have gone on a little bit longer, but anyway, take what I can get. That was really beautiful. I mean, you know, besides the, you can tell that the movie was really good and how it fits in with all that, you know, but just the music itself was great. You know, the guitars and the bass in there and everything was really, really fine. I caught the little didgeridoo at the end there, which was really nice, but it was, I don't know, I thought it was so cool. I mean, I can tell from the movie or from, you know, what I'm seeing here that, you know, in the movie, probably Paul Kelly's kind of an asshole, you know. But you can, in the song, you can understand his point of view. And whether it's right or wrong, you can understand where he's coming from. And certainly can understand where, well, I don't know what the character's name is, but I think that's Kev Carmody singing. But in any case, you can certainly understand his point of view too. But it's like two sides of a coin. It's really interesting. But like I say, the song itself is really nice, and you know, the vocals are great. Looks like a fly is buzzing around, so maybe I ought to kill it before it flies in front of the screen too many more times or lands on my shiny head there. So anyway, I'll be back in a minute and play something else. So hit like, subscribe, and we will see you all then. Bye-bye.